Hey there, it's Sanjay. The team is working really hard on the next season of Chasing Life, so we are going to share a CNN documentary series on medical marijuana. Now, the first documentary I did on the topic was back in 2013. And I gotta tell you, that special launched a 10-year exploration that has really opened my eyes to the potential benefits of cannabis, medical marijuana. So on this episode, we're gonna take a deeper look at cannabidiol, CBD. Today, it's part of our daily dialogue, and it's ignited a multi-billion dollar industry. Now, as you listen, keep in mind this documentary was first broadcast in 2019. You can hear part one now and part two next week. And coming soon to CNN, my seventh documentary called Weed. It's been more than 6 years since our first investigation into medical marijuana, since we first introduced you to an ingredient in the cannabis plant. Then, it was a word few could even pronounce, cannabidiol, or CBD. Well now, it's part of our daily dialogue, and it's ignited a multi-billion dollar industry. And that got us wondering, has it all gone too far? So we're back on the road, across the United States and around the world, searching for the truth about CBD. From oils to tinctures to lotions to lattes.
We sell pretty much everything, you name it.
In every shape and size, for pain, for anxiety, even soft skin.
This says it's for
hangover.
CBD is everywhere.
It's even in the water, it's in coffee. As you walk down the street, you see CBD signs everywhere.
We know it won't get you high, but we still don't know much more. Research is slim.
Hey, sweetheart.
Yet success stories are not.
She was dying. She was not going to live long.
Lives changed for the best. But now we are also learning about lives that were changed for the worse.
Experts are warning about a spice product that is being sold at local smoke shops. The concern centers around CBD oil.
You thought you might die?
Honestly, yeah.
What you thought was harmless could be dangerous.
Is the CBD supply chain safe?
And what's legal could be illegal. What you need to know. What we wanted to make sure you knew. This is Weed 5, the CBD craze.
As I'm driving down these Colorado roads, I realize that we should start this journey right where our first weed investigation began, back in 2013, with this family of pioneers, a band of brothers, who many think are responsible for starting a CBD craze.
These are the Stanley brothers.
What's going on, brothers?
When we first introduced you to them back in 2013...
I'm Joel.
I'm Josh.
They were young, unknown, and struggling with the new business.
Now everywhere you guys go, there's cameras chasing you in.
Now, June 2019, they're a bit older, more experienced, and very rich. Their CBD-based cannabis company is now a marijuana empire, publicly traded and worth an estimated $2 billion.
Has it affected you?
We're able to drive cars now that will actually get to where we're going.
That is true.
Back then, they were growing 600 pounds of medical marijuana a year on less than an acre.
So greenhouse one.
Greenhouse one.
Wow.
Betting the farm on THC, and on the side, experimenting with something few had considered.
There's nothing like this in the world. This plant's 21% CBD and less than 1% THC.
Initially, many wondered who would want a strain of marijuana that doesn't get you high. Remember, CBD is the non-psychoactive part of the plant. But Josh and his brothers knew even then that this had potential.
This area, without putting it lightly, is the future of medical marijuana.
Something the world would soon learn from a little girl named Charlotte. She has been called patient zero for the CBD craze.
Probably the most important thing I'll ever do was to help my own child and then share that information and help others.
Born with a rare form of epilepsy called Dravet syndrome, Charlotte had a seizure every 30 minutes, every one potentially fatal. When nothing helped,
this is Charlotte's web.
Her parents gave Charlotte the Stanley CBD oil.
She didn't have a seizure that day. And then she didn't have one the next day. And then the next day, I just thought, this is insane.
That was 6 years ago.
That, I think, really catapulted CBD into the national limelight as the most favored cannabinoid.
Cannabis researcher Dr. Donald Abrams believes that's when the CBD craze began.
It was sort of under the table until Charlotte Figge and Sanjay Gupta got together and threw it into the public domain.
The Stanleys and their special CBD strain became famous.
Charlotte's an explorer.
They've been contacted by thousands of families.
All of a sudden, everyone wanted the thing that had helped that little girl.
Jared Stanley and his brothers can't grow the plants fast enough.
And that third of an acre that I walked on more than 6 years ago has been replaced.
Now it's almost 800 acres.
This is going to be one of the fastest growing things that I think I've seen. I mean, in any kind of industry.
My poor brother Jared, who runs the entire agricultural division, the guy, he hasn't slept in 7 years.
As the Stanley's empire grew, so did the country's interest in CBD. A recent poll shows that 2 out of 3 Americans now know what CBD is, and 1 out of 7 use it.
I'm here in downtown New York City, which is like a lot of cities around the country. There are a ton of stores here selling CBD products. So I'm going to talk to somebody who's been following the CBD craze very closely. Hey, Lisa.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how you doing?
Nice to see you.
Good to see you. Thanks for making some time.
Yeah.
Lisa Gill is an investigative reporter for Consumer Reports. That's the Bible for mainstream consumer products. An unexpected place to read about CBD.
There are thousands upon thousands of products across the United States on store shelves, and not even counting what's online.
Mints, lotions, oils, bath bombs, gummies, popcorn.
What is this?
Even...
It looks like a joint.
Yeah, and it smells like marijuana. You smell that. I mean...
I feel like I would totally get busted.
I think I would too.
I swear, officer, it's CBD. It's totally...
All kidding aside, this is where it gets a little confusing. For decades, cannabis, including CBD, has been illegal federally. That all seemed to change with the passage of the 2018 Farm Bill, which technically made growing hemp with CBD and less than 0.3% THC legal. Or at least that's what most people think.
Even though it makes CBD federally legal, it allows the states to decide whether or not they're going to permit sales of it or permit farmers to grow it. So in my opinion, it's very confusing for an individual to try to understand, well, what is my state doing? What's even crazier is that lots of retailers sell it anyway. So you might walk into a store and just think, oh, it must be legal because it's here. In my personal 15 years of covering pharmaceutical medications, over-the-counter medications and supplements, there is not one compound like CBD.
Yet despite the confusion, people and companies are willing to take the chance. There's so much money to be made. The U.S. CBD market hit an estimated $591 million in 2018. And experts believe it could hit $22 billion by 2022. All because of those 7 brothers and that one little girl. But with success comes new concerns.
Anytime a craze comes out, you know, you have everybody trying to jump in the boat. That can be a little bit dangerous.
That side of the story, when we come back.
I was wondering what the holdup is. It's been like 2 months now, or a month and a half. This is very well documented.
These are complicated issues.
Very simple issues.
CBD did seem so simple then. It was 2014 when we first started covering the case of Vivian Wilson, a New Jersey toddler with seizures, just like Charlotte Figge.
Please don't let my daughter die, Governor.
Her father wanted some of Charlotte's oil to help his daughter, to save her life.
It's a horrible thing to have to see your daughter suffer like this.
After losing the fight to access CBD because of then-Governor Chris Christie's medical marijuana laws,
it will not happen on my watch, ever.
The family moved to Colorado.
Come on in.
To legally access the CBD oil the Stanleys had used with Charlotte, now called Charlotte's Web.
Vivian, take some medicine?
We were there in their new house for Vivian's first dose, 2014.
We came out here for CBD, and you want to believe that it's going to be the cure.
Is this her?
Yeah.
I'm excited to see her.
2019, when we arrived back in Denver to see the Wilsons again, we quickly learned that Vivian had tried many different kinds of CBD, and none of them had been a cure.
How are you?
We moved two-thirds of the way across the country for CBD, which is like something that you can like buy in your butter now.
Is it all good?
I don't think so. I think there's a lot of misinformation.
What you doing here?
Hi.
Hi.
Turns out Vivian's experience with what seemed to work miracles for some was not miraculous for her.
We saw this like initial improvement and things were good. The more we were increasing her CBD, the more seizures she started having at night, up to like 40 a night. And we just couldn't figure out what it was.
There's no evidence that CBD caused these seizures, but clearly it was no longer working for her.
It wasn't the benefit that they were necessarily seeking.
Dr. Kelly Knupp, Vivian's neurologist from Children's Hospital in Denver, remembers those early years for the Wilsons.
When a new medicine is started, we may see benefit for a couple of months, sometimes 6 months, 12 months, and then the benefit may gradually go away. And we don't fully understand why that is.
One day I just looked at Brian and I said, like, you know, she just seized all night long. And I said, it's the CBD, I'm done. We stopped, and she never had another focal seizure again at night in her sleep.
It was the exact opposite of what we found just 60 miles away. When we arrived at the Figgy's doorstep.
Sanjay!
Remember me?
Welcome back!
Hey, Charlotte. Hey, sweetheart. You remember me? I think that's a yes, maybe.
It was more than we expected, and it was more than Paige had ever allowed herself to hope for.
You're walking pretty good, sweetheart.
I can't imagine back then seeing her at 12 years old and what that would look like. She was dying. She was not going to live long.
How is Charlotte doing?
She's good. She's stable, and she doesn't take any medications, just this oil that she's been using for more than half of her life.
But why did CBD work so well for Charlotte, but not for Vivian?
What is different about the children who responded to CBD from those who didn't? So I'm wondering if there is some honeymoon effect there as well.
There is a suspicion that maybe it works by increasing the blood level of the anti-seizure medicine that the children were already on.
Some think this honeymoon period that kids like Vivian experienced might be explained by her liver.
Good job.
CBD works in the liver, in the enzymes that break down other prescription medicines. And CBD inhibits those enzymes so that they don't break down pharmaceuticals to the extent that they should be broken down, allowing them to get a higher level and perhaps more effective or perhaps more toxic.
The fact that CBD can affect your liver enzymes and change the way drugs interact with your body could potentially be very dangerous. 60% of medications are broken down in the liver by a group of enzymes that could be affected by CBD use. They include drugs you might use every day, antibiotics, antihistamines, antidepressants.
it's not entirely benign, and that's one of my concerns about the widespread use of CBD.
That's medicine in that bag?
That's what I think. Trying to prove it.
When I first met Donald Abrams 4 years ago, he was on the cutting edge of cannabis research. So much promise then, but he says not much progress now. He does still believe in the potential healing power of marijuana, but is concerned about CBD alone.
The CBD craze that we're in, I think, is unprecedented really in the history of medicine. It's a compound that has gotten way ahead of any research to support the claims that are being made.
Abrams was part of the team of doctors in 2017 with the National Academy of Sciences that did what is considered the most comprehensive review of all the studies done on the benefits of cannabis.
There are only about five in the medical literature studies looking at the therapeutic benefits of CBD.
Not only are there few studies, the studies that we have are not very good quality.
And there's hardly any research at all for the benefits of all those wellness products in stores.
There's very little for a lot of these things, but the potential side effect, particularly for low doses, episodically, is pretty low.
Might help, can hurt, why not? That's why so many people use CBD. And it's something we've heard for years, since our investigation first began.
Whoa.
And now, as we keep digging, we're learning that it could sometimes hurt. In life, everyone has days they wish they could just forget. For college junior Jay Jenkins, that day was May 8th, 2018.
So you're sitting there in the passenger seat just like you are now.
Right, just like I am now. My buddy asks if I'd ever tried CBD oil. So I said no, wasn't really interested in it. You know, why would I? And he asked a few more times and eventually I gave in and said sure, you know, I'll try it.
They drove to a convenience store and bought a CBD product labeled YOLO. YOLO stands for You Only Live Once.
Why did you do it?
I didn't think there was any risk in trying it. You know, I'd never heard about anybody having any negative effects from it. So I thought that I had nothing to lose. I took two puffs off of it. Next thing I know, I'm feeling crazy and not thinking straight, not being able to move.
Within seconds, Jay appeared to have lost consciousness and started to have frightening hallucinations. His friend drove him to Lexington Medical Center, where he started having seizures.
On the Glasgow Coma Scale, they said that I scored a 3.
So 15 is basically 15. Normal, and 3 is brain dead, essentially.
Yes, sir.
You thought you might die?
Honestly, yeah. At the time, you know, I was seeing all this crazy stuff going on in my head, all these crazy hallucinations going on. I thought that I was in hell and that I was already dead.
What did the doctors say to you? What do you remember?
They said that if I had gotten there much later, then I wouldn't have been able to survive.
He recovered physically from the trauma of it all. But make no mistake, he is still suffering mentally and asking lots of questions. What was in this CBD oil? What got him so sick? Isn't CBD supposed to be safe? What Jay would soon learn is that around the same time, people 2,000 miles away in Salt Lake City, Utah, had also been getting sick from a similar substance.
Experts are warning about a spice product that is being sold at local smoke shops. The concern centers around a product labeled as CBD oil.
People started calling Utah's Poison Control Center and showing up in the emergency rooms saying they had used a liquid CBD oil. Barbara Inslee Crouch, executive director of Poison Control, remembers that very first call.
One of our specialists said to me, you know what, this is really odd. You know, I have this case, this doc called me about it and sort of described that this was supposedly CBD they'd vaped.
As more calls came in, Crouch knew something was wrong.
First of all, CBD is the non-psychoactive component of the cannabis plant, right? So the first thing we said is, wait a minute, this is not consistent with CBD. I contacted the health department, said, something's going on here. I don't know what it is. This doesn't make sense, but something is going on.
Everything pointed to the one thing most patients had in common. They had used a counterfeit product labeled YOLO, CBD oil, similar to the one Jay took. So Crouch went to a local smoke shop to obtain an unopened bottle for the police.
The gentleman showed me the product and he asked me what my tolerance for getting high was. It was clear to me that the overall intent was not necessarily therapeutic.
Is this product in the bottle something that's from an accredited laboratory, or is it something that's made in somebody's garage?
Agent Christopher L. Scholes with the State Bureau of Investigation was assigned to the case as part of a newly created task force.
In the early phases, we were just seeking to collect the samples, get them to the lab, and determine what the substance actually was. When we had these tested by the state crime lab, there was absolutely no CBD in the actual bottles. It was entirely a 4-cyanocumobutanoca compound.
That's a synthetic cannabinoid that has been associated with fatalities in Europe.
Eventually, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention got involved. Roberta Horth is an epidemiologist there.
We were fortunate, you know, in this cluster that we didn't detect any fatalities.
When you talked to the victims, did you tell them what you guys had found?
They were quite angry. They weren't expecting that when they walk into a shop that they're going to get a product that has been tainted.
In the end, law enforcement was unable to pinpoint where these toxic products were coming from.
So ultimately with this, we were never able to find out exactly who it was that was making it and distributing it. No criminal charges were filed.
And that is a consequence of this CBD craze. In the middle of this circus, countless people got sick, and the people to blame simply disappeared.
After it's all said and done, it shocked me too that, you know, such a simple thing did so much damage to me, almost killed me.
That is not what should be happening to a product that you just buy, you know, at any store. It's unconscionable.
And potentially just the beginning.
This issue could become worse, much worse, before it gets better. That's what's really scary.
We'll be back next week with part two of the CBD craze, where I'm going to dig into some of the dangers associated with vaping. Thanks for listening.